I'm sorry. Give me a minute. I spend my days thinking about what I should talk to you about the next time we come to the spring. But there are so many things to share. Sometimes I just don't know where to start. Traveling together is so much fun. But it would be even better if I weren't a horse.
It's almost too cold to bear. But if we don't retrieve the scepter, Medea and I may never return to normal. We'll just have to grin and bear it. Let's keep pushing on. At least moving might help us to warm up a little. I shouldn't have to put up with being in a freezing place like this. It's all Dormagus's fault. Well, but he's dead now. So I suppose it's that Leo what's-his-name's fault. I don't know. A dog of all things. Oh, brr.
Oh, stop your whinging, Grandad. It ain't as if we've got a sweat on, you know. Just get on with it.
I beg your pardon? How uncalled for! I don't see why I shouldn't be able to say whatever I please. You've no right to talk to me like that. No right at all. I'm absolutely livid. Livid, I tell you. I'm going on ahead.
That dog over there is called Boris. He's the one who dug us out from the snow. What a dog. He's a lot more use than a certain king, don't you think? And he smells a bit better, too.
I heard that, Angelo. More use than a certain king, you say? How dare you? Honestly, who do you think called for the dog's help in the first place?
By the fire and warm your bones. I will bring you some of my nook grass tea.
Please, drink. This nook grass tea will keep you warm even in the bitter cold of this snowy land.
How terribly kind of you. First you save us from the avalanche, then you put us up for the night, and now you warm our innards. Now that's what I call hospitality.
And what's really amazing is that you helped a weird old monster like him in the first place.
You loathsome lowlife! You, of all people, have no right to call me weird!
It is true, that his appearance is a little unusual. But when you get to my age, you learn not to judge a horse by its harness. And of course, I would help anyone who was in trouble so far from civilization.
I hope you don't mind me asking, but why do you live all the way out here on your own?
Of course I do not mind, dear. There is an old ruin behind my house. My ancestors have looked after it generation after generation. It is a family duty. But that will all end with me. I have no one to follow in my footsteps when my life is finished.
Really? It must be pretty tough living on your own like this, duty or no duty.
It is comfortable enough. I have lived here since I was a child, so it is not a hardship. Besides, to live life is not to walk through a meadow. And from time to time, people get lost here in the mountains, like you. So I am not lonely. And I always have Boris to keep me company.
Ah, on the subject of dogs, we had something to ask you, Marta. This will sound a bit strange, but we're pursuing a big black dog, and we heard that he might have been headed in this direction. There's a good chance he may have come this way. Have you seen anything?
No. I am sorry. The only dog I know about is big old Boris over there. Sorry I cannot be of more help. You should ask where there is a lot of people. If you go down the mountain and go to the north, you will come to a town called Orkutsk. Maybe someone will know something there.
Ah, that sounds like an excellent idea. Right then, chaps, there's no time to lose.
Oh, yo-yo, if you are hasty, others will only be amused. That is an old saying here. One should not be so eager to go back out into the blizzard. The night is coming. Why don't you rest here? I am sure the blizzard will be gone by morning, so you can leave for Orkutsk then.
Yes, yes. Wise words, my good woman. Very well, we shall rest here for the night.
Go north from the bottom of the mountain, and you will come to Orkutsk. Please be careful on your journey.
By George! Princess! Are you all right? Were you cold in the night?
Forgive me, but I must ask you a favor. If you meet with a man called Marek in Orkutsk, please give this to him. He is probably working with herbs like I am. I would be grateful if you could give him that bag. Спасибо. Thank you.
Right then! Off to Orkutsk! Toodly bye!
Thank you.
Dobroe utra. Good morning. So you have found my herb garden. This cave is just the right temperature and humidity for them, and it is the only place I can grow my nook grass. Beyond those iron bars is the ruin I told you about. I usually keep it locked. It is a very special place, so I cannot allow visitors inside. Forgive me.
Oh, blimey, Grandma.